What happens when applications die? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question I got. While I'm not particularly concerned about my privacy, all that stuff on the internet was out there before the internet, it was just a little harder to find, I'm not particularly trusting. I realize that TrueCrypt was open source and LastPass, etc. are all paid services, but what happens if they go belly up? What happens if they hire some idiot and all of their software goes up in smoke? I have a hard time trusting these services, or any others for that matter, and these are things I want under my control. What you're describing happens more often than you might think. There are people who use an application for some time and suddenly find that the company is no longer in business and there's no way to get an update. Sometimes that means they can't migrate to current versions of their operating systems if they want to keep running that now unsupported software. It's something I consider when selecting important software. Depending on what programs we're talking about, there are approaches you can use to back up your data and protect yourself from potential software obsolescence or even disappearance. It's critical for utilities to keep important data in proprietary formats like password managers such as 1Password and others, to support the ability to export your data into a common, simple, open file format. For example, they should support exporting everything to a text file, a CSV file that can be read by Excel, or a PDF that can be read just about anywhere. That way, if something ever happens to the utility or its ability to provide X functionality, you have a backup. Not only that, but you have a backup that's in a standard file format you can use or you can import into a replacement utility. That's one of the reasons that I stopped using RoboForm many years ago. At the time, they had no export capability, but I'm told that they do now, right? With encryption utilities like TrueCrypt, its successor VeraCrypt or Cryptomator, the approach is a little different. These utilities are tasked with encrypting or providing encrypted storage for important data files. The approach to protecting yourself from the program going away is fairly simple. Keep a copy of the program that works. Presumably, you can always use your older version to access your data. That happened to prove true when TrueCrypt magically went away some years ago. Back up your data in unencrypted form separately. Secure it using a different tool or mechanism. In the case of tools like VeraCrypt, that means backing up the contents of the VeraCrypt drive or volume, not the encrypted volume itself. As long as you have a copy of the files you need outside of this utility, albeit perhaps in a significantly less convenient yet still secure format or location, then it's no disaster if the utility stops working someday. And of course, as long as you keep a working version of the utility around, you're protected nonetheless. But Leo, I hear you saying, we use tools like VeraCrypt and 1Password to keep things secure. Doesn't keeping those unencrypted exports around leave us just as vulnerable as not using the utilities at all? Well, yeah, if you leave those unencrypted files where anyone can get at them. Don't do that. You must secure those unencrypted backups. That could mean storing them offline in a secure location. It could mean encrypting them with a different tool. For example, if you encrypt your 1Password export using a tool like 7-Zip with encryption, then everything remains secure, and you actually only lose access to your information if both tools become completely unusable. Unlikely, as we've seen, at the same time. Even more unlikely. So, what do? I follow my own advice. The unencrypted files that I store in Cryptomator are backed up nightly into an encrypted .zip archive, which is then stored in a secure location. And I periodically export my 1Password database, which is bundled into a password-protected zip file, and then stored in a secure location. When it comes to popular and pervasive software like VeraCrypt or 1Password, my belief is that the risks are quite minimal. You may not have to take all the steps I've listed. The only exception might be if you plan for your backups to be accessible decades from now. I expect that plain text and CSV will outlast almost any proprietary format and will in fact be readable on whatever passes for a computer 20 years from now. If a utility is destined to die, there's usually lots of notice, and you'll be able to make other plans. Even though TrueCrypt's demise was sudden, existing copies of the tool kept working, giving those so inclined plenty of opportunity to research and move to alternatives. The risks are with the smaller operators or software destined for smaller markets. There may not be an equivalent common format to export to, or the export functionality might not be a priority. In cases like this, honestly, there's little to be done other than to stay on top of upgrades if practical, or possibly keep a copy of the utility and an operating environment in which it works for as long as possible. It also might be a time to investigate more exportable alternatives. A great case in point, recent, is Microsoft's Publisher. It's going away, and yeah, it stores in a completely proprietary format. Bottom line here is to back up. Above all, back up. But if you can, back up your encrypted and proprietary data in unencrypted forms and in open formats. That's the safest way to protect you from possible problems down the road. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/15642. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.